Gentlemen, milady, you will always remember this as the day that you almost caught Captain Jack Sparrow.
Piracy in this film by Disney and Jerry Bruckheimer is displayed in a comical and entertaining light. But was it really this way in the real 18th century? Google it. But if you're too lazy to do that, I, Garrett, will tell you. The theme for this year's history affair is revolution, reaction, and reform. But before you understand how my topic relates to the theme, I must inform you about the average life on a pirate ship.
Yo ho ho, mateys, this here landlubber in a cheap costume don't know a thing about living under a Jolly Roger like me, for I am the great Captain Andrew Stinglestein. See, the first thing about living on the pirate ship is that you want to collect as much loot as possible without getting caught. Then,
strangely enough, aboard a pirate ship there was democracy, as they would elect their captains. Upon joining the crew, pirates were to obey the pirate rules, the articles. Included in this set of rules was a common article. Each pirate must have a semi-equal share of any stolen booty. This exceptions to this rule were the captain and various other members of the crew, like the quartermaster, who got a fraction more of jewels than the common folk.
Arrgh, that be true, but I have some knowledge that's much better than this here's morsel's mumble-jumble. See, I've rowed on many a ships, and they're all different. When I was a young lad, I rowed on a sloop known as the Pathetic Barnacle. I abandoned the ship after a mutiny happened. See, I didn't want to get caught.
Ah, here we go. This is a perfect example of how our topic relates to the theme, mutiny. The mutineers took over a pirate ship if they didn't like how the ship was run, or the captain just wasn't a jolly guy. It's a clear revolution. Another occurrence of mutiny was by the captain dubbed Long Ben, also known as Henry Avery. He mutinied against Commander Captain Gibson aboard the Duke. Avery put the captain ashore and sailed the renamed ship Charles II.
Sure me timbers, you know a bounty. Well, so do I. After I escaped the Pathetic Barnacle, I went headed in my longboat toward the New England. Then I hitched a ride with the one and only Captain Kidd.
Did you know that William Kidd?
Captain!
Was a privateer for the King of England. He and his crew didn't find any pirate ships along the African coast, so instead of hunting down pirates, he became one.
We was then scandaled by the devilish Earl of Bellamont as Captain handed over those legal document pages he could have used to prove he wasn't guilty of nothing he wasn't supposed to do.
That's extraordinary! It also displays...
One good thing did come out of this, though.
What might that be?
I learned a ballad called The Ballad of Captain Kidd. Well, shall I sing?
No, thank you.
My name was Robert Kidd as I sailed. My name was Robert Kidd as I sailed.
It's really okay.
My name was Robert Kidd. God's law I did forbid. So wickedly I did when I sailed.
Wonderful. As I was saying, the story of Kidd displays how people in the 1700s reacted to pirates. They hung him, of course.
Oh my.
Yes, he was tried for piracy and murder. He did both of these things. He murdered William Moore for a good reason. He had plans of the mutiny against him.
Oh, Will was a good mate of mine.
People of the 1700s weren't the only ones who reacted to pirates. People today still react to them. They make movies like the Pirates of the Caribbean series. They're also great topics for TV shows and children's books. Children's stories, however, overuse stereotypes like eye patches, gold teeth, peg legs, hooks, and bandanas to hide their hair.
Ah, my mother used to read me those books.
Interesting. Another example of how pirates were reacted to was by the governments.
Oh, I can answer that one. Pick me.
Captain Stinglestein.
The governments kind of saw this piracy stuff as a sort of battle between the main European powers. Arr!
Very good. I think this is an excellent opportunity to talk about privateers.
Then who was?
Privateers. Privateers are men who are contracted by the government to plunder from other nations.
So like good old Captain Kidd?
Yes. Another example of a privateer is Sir Francis Drake. He plundered from the Spanish Main for England. This is an example of two different reactions of pirates. England reacted to him as a hero, yet the Spanish reacted to him as a scoundrel.
Blackbeard!
Excuse me?
Ain't he one of those privateers?
No, he's...
Speaking of Captain Beard, after a few years of searching, I found myself aboard the Queen Anne's Revenge.
Oh my, you seem to really get around. Did you know that the Queen Anne's Revenge was originally a French slave ship known as the Concorde?
Arrgh! We sailed for 2 years around the coast of Carolina. When we were going to battle, Captain Blackbeard would light his beard on fire. That even scared myself along with the rest of the crew.
Whoa! Sounds scary.
One of them days, Captain decided to sink his beloved vessel to his good old Steed Bonnet and take all the booty for himself. I decided to stick with the captain and we hopped aboard the Adventure. We sailed around for a few days until Lieutenant Maynard came from Virginia and blocked us in Ocracoke Inlet. That night I asked Blackbeard himself where his treasure was and if his wife knew. He said that besides himself, only the devil did.
So I'm guessing you didn't figure that out.
Nope! The very next morning, Leard used his clever captaining skills and tricked one of the sloops into a sandbar. Then Maynard and his crew leapt aboard the Adventurer and engaged in brutal bloodshed. Finally, Blackbeard took 21 slashes and 9 hits to...
Before what?
Yes, one of our opponents sliced it off. Most of our crew fell dead and got captured on that day, too.
Then how did you escape and not die?
I did it! I'm dead!
What?
Just pulling your peg leg, mate. Jump ship right before Black Caesar almost blew the ship up. I swear I even saw Blackbeard's decapitated corpse swimming around the ship. I called Marco, but I didn't get an answer.
Wow, what a story. Your Blackbeard story reminds me of the third element in this year's history fair, reform. See, Maynard reformed many pirates when he hung Blackbeard's head from the bow of the ship.
Well, I wasn't going to talk about that, but okay.
Governments were reformed also. They had to make new rules and regulations to restrict piracy. Pirates again were reformed when the new rules and regulations stopped the scum from pirating.
Arr, that be true, but I'd be a little offended by you saying stuff like that.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Don't get your pantaloons in a knot.
Yeah! Off to Davy Jones' locker he is. Well, I might as well tell you the rest of my story. I got my own ship soon after. They insecure an enemy. I plundered just till just a little bit ago when piracy kind of went down the drain. The golden age of piracy was over. Either there weren't ships to rob, or they just got bored. As that dead guy would say, this is reform. The pirates just stopped stealing loot. I was real disappointed. And although the romance of piracy is gone, it will still remain strong in our hearts. How the pirates revolted against the law. How many of us will still write books and make movies about them. And how pirates reformed and reformed others. I hope you scallywags learned something from this documentary. Now go and get out of my face!